Okay, now I will talk about the unit step function. So these unit step functions are also called as the Heaviside function. So it's unit step functions. Unit step functions. Are also called as the Heaviside functions. Heaviside functions. In fact, it's just one function. So if it is, it will be function. Okay, Heaviside function or unit step function. So this unit step function is defined as follows. So u is equal to it is 0 for values of t less than a, or if it is equal to 1 for values of t greater than a, where a is greater than or equal to 0. So for example, we can represent the unit step function as this. So if it is t, and then if it is u on this axis, so if for certain value of a, so this function will be 0, and then suddenly after that a, this function will be equal to 1. Okay, so this is a kind of like on and off type of function. Okay. So this function has some applications in mathematics, so that's why we need to consider this function. So along with this unit step function, so for example, if this unit step function u is applied, so this is actually represented as like this. Its complete notation is like this: ut minus a. Okay, it's complete notation. So if we apply this unit step function to some other function, say t, and that means we multiply it with some other function t, so that function will be 0 for t, and that function will be 0 for t is less than a. Okay, so because for t is less than a, u will be 0. Okay, so t is less than a, this will be 0, so the function will be also 0. For t is greater than a, u will be 1, so this function will be f of t. Okay, so in this way we can apply this function. So for example, if function of t is, say, if function of t is sine of t, okay, so if this is t axis and then this is function axis, so it will be, the curve will be like this. Okay, so if we apply this function with the, so for example, t is equal to if you multiply this function ft times u of t minus pi. Okay, so for any value of t less than pi, u will be 0, so we will get this portion will be turned off actually. So if this is 0, then this is pi, then this is 2 pi. So the changed plot will be like this. Because for any value of pi, it will be greater than 0. Okay. So many times this function, unit step function, is applied to shifted function. Okay, is applied to a shifted function. So for example, what is a shifted function? So if f of t is sine t, so what will be f of t minus pi? Okay, t minus pi. What is f of t minus pi? In this case, if f of t is sine t, what will be f of t minus pi? It will be sine t minus pi. So the graph of sine t minus pi will be will start from pi, because if t is equal to pi, okay, if t is equal to pi, then it will be like this graph. Okay, and if we for t is less than pi, so it will be minus pi, so it will be on the other side. But if we multiply ft minus pi with the unit step function of t minus pi, okay, so then what will be the graph? So anything before pi will vanish, okay, anything before pi will vanish, and then the graph will be like this. So it will be, so if we want to shift, that means if we want to really want to shift this function of t by a, then we have to take the we want anything to vanish before that pi, then we have to shift that function by t minus pi, and then we have to multiply it by the unit step function. Okay, so with this in mind, let's look at the Laplace properties of this unit step function. Okay, so what will be the Laplace transform of u t minus a? Okay, so the Laplace transform of u t minus a will be, so by definition we can write this Laplace transform as from 0 to infinity e power minus st into u t minus a dt. Okay, so now from the properties of the unit step function, we know that for any value of t less than a, this unit step function is 0. So it means that it's we can divide it into from 0 to a e power minus st u t minus a, okay, dt, and plus from a to infinity e power minus st u t minus a into dt. So now we can further write it like this. So now this is now is 0, because u t minus a will be 0 in this range, so this integral will be 0, so because the integral of 0 is 0. Okay, and then from here it will be, because u t minus a in this range will be 1, so it will be from a to infinity e power minus st over into dt. So now we can evaluate it, e power minus st over s minus s, and then from infinity to a. So e power minus infinity is 0, and e power minus s a, so e power minus a s, and divided by minus s, so it will be e power minus a s divided by s. So it means that the Laplace transform of unit step function is e power minus a s over s. Okay so this is the Laplace transform of the unit step function. Okay, so now if I just recall that the Laplace transform of e power a t times some function of t was equal to f of s minus a. So for example, if the Laplace transform of f of t was only f of t was f of s, if we multiply f of t by e power a t, its Laplace transform will be given by f of s minus a. So this type of theorem is called as the s shifting theorem. Okay, s shifting theorem. Okay, and but there is another shifting theorem which is called as the t shifting theorem. Okay, so this t shifting theorem is about the Laplace transform of f of t minus a times unit of t minus a. Okay, It is about this Laplace transform. So now we will find out what is it. Okay, that is the T-shifting theorem. Okay, so what is the Laplace transform of this? So by definition, this will be the from 0 to infinity e power minus st into f of t minus a and u of t minus a. Okay, and dt. And then we can write it like from a to infinity, because from 0 to a it will be 0, because u of t is 0. So we can write it like this, from a to infinity e power minus st f of t minus a dt. Okay, we can write it like this. So now let's take a substitution. So v is equal to t minus a, so it will give that dv will be equal to dt. So we can replace dt with dv, t minus a with v, and we can also replace t with, because t will be equal to a plus v. Okay, so what we do is we can make these replacements. And also how about the limits? So for example, when t is equal to a, because now the integral will be in terms of v, so when t is equal to a, so when t is equal to a, then v will be equal to 0. From this equation, if we put t is equal to a minus a, it will be 0. Okay, so this limit will be 0, and then the upper limit will be infinity, because when t is infinity, so infinity minus y a is infinity, so v will be infinity. So the limits will be now 0 to infinity e power minus s, and t is a plus v. Okay, a plus v, and then this will be f of v. Okay, f of v, and then this is dv. Okay, so now we have to just rearrange these terms. So this is 0 to infinity, and then this is e power minus s v, and then e power minus a v. Okay, sorry, this will be e power a s, not v. So it will be e power minus a s, e power minus a s, and minus a v f v d v. So now we can, because all the this integral is in terms of v, so e power minus a s will be a constant, so it will be e power minus a s will be outside, and then 0 to infinity e power minus a v, and then f v and dv. So what is this integral? This integral is actually the Laplace transform of f of v. Okay, Laplace transform of f of v. So it will be e power minus as, and then it is f of s, the Laplace transform. Well, what we have found out is that the Laplace transform of f of t minus a is equal into u of t minus a is equal to e power minus as into f of s. So this type of theorem is called as the T-shifting theorem. So it means that if we have a term which is in the Laplace transform of, if we have a function which is in terms of some the Laplace transform of some function in T, and then that is being multiplied by e power minus as, then it will be a Laplace transform of shifted function f of t minus a into u t minus a. So this is called as the T-shifting theorem. Okay, T-shifting theorem. Okay, so we have the S-shifting and as well as T-shifting. So this is the F-shifting theorem, and this is the T-shifting theorem. Okay, so we will now take one example to apply this theorem.